No matter how proficient you are in Photoshop CS3, there will be a time when you need some help. So you can see up in the menu bar we have the appropriately named menu Help. And when we choose this, we see we have a lot of things in here. First of all, we have Photoshop Help. And when you choose this, this opens a separate little application. And the Help Viewer will open in a second. And there's all kinds of cool stuff in here that we can look at. Let me go ahead and resize this. And what you can see here is we can browse from the different applications we have in our CS3 suite. We can also do a search. And we can look at the contents of the Help, as well as look at an index. So we can choose things based on the numerics or in the alphabetical section here. So I'm going to go back to Contents. And as you see, we have these little arrows, and when you click on an arrow, more stuff is in there. There is help aplenty. It is help all over the place. What we can also do is once again enter our own thing. So I can, for example, type in RGB, hit return on the keyboard, and see what pops up. And it says my search in RGB found 50 results, so I can find out all about RGB. How cool is that? So let me go ahead and hide this guy from now. Go back to Photoshop and show you that in the Help menu we have even more things, such as patent and legal notices. In other words, don't steal Photoshop. Bad for you. System info. Good times right here. Now, whenever you call the tech support department of any computer manufacturer about your application, they're going to ask you several things. First of all, they're going to ask you, what operating system are you currently using? As you see here, I'm using Macintosh OS 10.4.8. I can also see more about my system, and I can also see whatever plugins I currently have installed, because 9 times out of 10, it's a plugin that's bad. The cool thing about this system info is not just for Photoshop, it's for anything. So if you want to copy your system information to upload to any tech support or forum, just copy what you want, click copy, and then you can paste that into the application of your choice. So what you would do is probably send that information to the Adobe people if you need some help. We can also talk about how to register and deactivate your version of Photoshop. Now, the reason you would choose to deactivate is because when you install Photoshop CS3, it is specifically registered to the computer you're on. So we have to deactivate the version, or the beta version, if you're installing Photoshop for the first time. And by the way, this is important. If you have problems installing Photoshop CS3, you have to deactivate your beta. Okay, so make sure you just go online, do a little search for, you know, registration problems with Photoshop, and you'll find out how to deactivate the beta and all that kinds of stuff. Now, updates. Updates are important because Photoshop will tell you what new versions of the software is available for the bridge and all kinds of applications regarding the Photoshop Creator Suite. We can also go to Photoshop Online and go to the Adobe website. And we also have some help topics here, some how-tos, so you can quickly see how to create web images and how to do other things. And one thing that I always get a little chuckle from is this part down here, how to create how-tos. So you can put your own how-tos in here. And it's kind of helpful, I guess, if you're running a design studio and you have your own specific way of doing things, or a specific way you want the new people to do certain things, you can create a how-to in here, like how to not take a 3-hour lunch break. So that kind of thing. So once again, help is very critical. If you want to find out more information about certain applications or topics in Photoshop and the Creator Suite, and how to deal with your registration and your system info, as well as how to create your own how-tos, or look at the built-in how-tos that come with your install of Photoshop CS3.